وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In this Ramadan Daily Droplets, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be talking about Ramadan as a time for fear and hope. Allah Azza wa Jal, He told us in the Qur'an, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ وَيَرْجُونَ رَحْمَتَهُ وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ Surah Al-Isra, ayah number 57. Allah Azza wa Jal told us about those among His awliya from the prophets and the righteous and how they seek a means of nearness to Allah. They are the ones who call upon Allah, seeking a means of nearness to Him. Which of them is closer? And they hope in the mercy of Allah and they fear His punishment. Here, Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned that this ayah, it contains the three essential elements that are always present within the life of a Muslim. It contains fear and hope that the righteous people, the people who are righteous and near to Allah from the prophets and those with them, alayhim as-salatu was-salam, they used to fear and they used to hope. يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةً They hoped for the mercy of Allah. وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابًا And they feared the punishment of Allah. And they had يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said this indicates al-mahabba, the love that they had for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they joined between hope and fear, and they joined between hope and fear and love. And Allah Azza wa Jalla told us in Surah Al-Anbiya, after mentioning Ayyub and Yunus and Zakariya, Allah Azza wa Jalla told us, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ In ayah number 90 from Surah Al-Anbiya, after Allah Azza wa Jal told us about Zakariya and how Allah Azza wa Jal gave him Yahya, Allah Azza wa Jal said, those prophets, they used to race to do good deeds and they used to call upon us in hope and fear. And they were submissive towards us, humble and submissive. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا They called upon us in hope and in fear. That's how the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام used to be. And Imam Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى he said الْقَلْبُ فِي سَيْرِهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الطَّائِرِ He said the heart on its journey to Allah عز وجل is like a bird. فَالْمَحَبَّةُ رَأْسُهُ وَالْخَوْفُ وَالرَّجَاءُ Janaha, he said that loving Allah is the head of the bird and fear and hope are the two wings. Whenever the head and the two wings are healthy and sound, then the bird is able to fly well. وَمَتَى قُطِعَ الرَّأْسِ مَاتَ الطَّائِرِ And when the head is cut off, the bird will die. وَمَتَى فُقِدَ الْجَنَاحَانِ فَهُوَ عُرْضَةٌ لِكُلِّ صَائِدٍ وَكَاسِرٍ And whenever one of the two wings is lost, then the bird becomes prey for every hunter, every beast of prey that wishes to snatch it and kill it. It can't escape them because its wings are not in good condition. And this is the example of love and fear and hope. So a Muslim has to balance between fear and hope in the different things that come into them in the different situations they experience in their life. When they find themselves to be relaxed and too hopeful, and a person says, Allah Kareem, Allah is forgiving, Allah will forgive me, it doesn't matter what I do, this person is lacking fear, they need to increase their fear. And when a person finds themselves to be despairing, they say, it doesn't matter what I'm going to do, I feel like I will just be from the people of the fire. Then this person is lacking hope. Rather, some of the scholars, they said, and this is narrated from Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, and many others as well before him, rahimahullah, that he said that when a person is healthy and well, they should slightly incline more towards fear. And when they are sick and weak, they should incline more towards hope. But here, just like the bird when it's flying and the wind blows in different directions and different things happen, so the bird adjusts its wings. One wing moves up, one wing moves down. And it moves its wings in order to balance itself. So this is how a person should be. And this is the excellent example Ibn al-Qayyim gave, rahimahullah ta'ala, about fear and hope, that you have to adjust them throughout the different situations in your life. You never ever feel despair. And you never ever feel true hopeful to the point that you become lazy. And you say that whatever happens, I'm sure that I will be successful. And that's why Shaykh bin Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, الواجب على المسلم ألا يقنط ولا يأمن ويكون بين الرجاء والخوف. He said the obligatory thing upon the Muslim is not to feel despair nor to feel safe that nothing will happen to them. Rather, they should be between hope and fear. لأن الله ذم الآمنين وذم القانطين. Because Allah Azza wa Jal rebuked those who feel safe and rebuked those who feel despair. Feeling safe meaning they feel that no matter what they do, or they feel that even though they have sins, they will not be harmed. Nothing bad will happen to them. فَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ وَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, do they feel safe from the plan of Allah? I.e. they feel safe that despite their sins, and despite the things they have done, that nothing will happen to them. They will never, no punishment, nothing bad. They will just be able to do whatever they want, or doesn't matter what the sins they have done, and nothing will happen to them. Nobody feels safe of the plot of Allah except for the losing people. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Do not despair of the mercy of Allah. So when you bring these two things together, is that the person doesn't feel despair, and doesn't, so that they stop doing deeds, and doesn't feel so much confidence that they feel that nothing will happen to them no matter what they do. Rather, they are between hope and between fear. They fear Allah. They're scared of the consequences of their sins, and they rush to make tawbah, and they ask Allah Azza wa Jal for His forgiveness. And Al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, المؤمن يعمل بالطاعات وهو مشفق وجل خائف. He said, a believer does acts of obedience while they are in a state of fear, while they are trembling and they're scared. والفاجر يعمل بالمعاصي وهو آمن. And the wicked person does evil deeds believing that there's nothing going to happen to them at all. SubhanAllah, look at the difference. The believer does acts of worship in a state of being scared, in a state of trembling, in a state of fear. And the disbeliever or the fajr, the wicked person, does every kind of sin and doesn't care. The believer is scared. Didn't Allah Azza wa Jal say, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ in Surah Al-Mu'minun. Those people who give what they give and their hearts are trembling out of a fear it will not be accepted from them. And Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about this ayah. And she thought it was about the people of al-fujur, the people who steal and the people who commit adultery and the people who do all kinds of evil deeds. She thought that they were the ones whose hearts were trembling. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to her, لا يبنة الصديق. No, O daughter of a Siddiq. This is the one who prays. This is the one who fasts. This is the one who gives charity. But they're scared that it will not be accepted from them. So the believer joins between these two things. And in the month of Ramadan, we have many reasons to be incredibly hopeful. And we have many reasons to be scared. From the reasons that we have to be scared and to be hopeful is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. رَغِمَ أَنْفُ رَجُلٍ دَخَلَ عَلَيْهِ رَمَضَانٍ ثُمَّ انْسَلَخَ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُغْفَرَ لَهُ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, may the person's nose be rubbed in the dust, the one who Ramadan comes and goes and that person wasn't forgiven, before that person was forgiven. And this has both fear and hope. It makes us scared. We become scared and we become fearful that we might be from those people who Ramadan comes and we don't get forgiven. But at the same time, it also makes us hopeful for all the opportunities there are for forgiveness in the month of Ramadan. And what makes us hopeful is the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu. إذا كان أول ليلة من شهر رمضان صفدت الشياطين ومردت الجن وغلقت أبواب النار فلم يفتح منها باب وفتحت أبواب الجنة فلم يغلق منها باب وينادي مناد يا باغي الخير أقبل ويا باغي الشر أقصر ولله عتقاء من النار وذلك كل ليلة. That when the month of Ramadan comes, the shayateen and this obstinate jinn are tied up and the doors of Jahannam are closed and not a single door is open, and the doors of Jannah are open and not a single one is closed, and a caller cries out, ya baghi al-khayri aqbil, O doer of good, come forward, wa ya baghi al-sharri aqsir, and O doer of evil, desist. And Allah has people that He frees from the fire every single night in the month of Ramadan. Every night, including the very last night or the very last day. So let nobody say that I haven't done enough or that there hasn't. What about the days? There's not enough remaining. There remain nights of Ramadan. And you have the chance now to be from one of those utaqa, those people who have been freed from the fire. Does that not give you hope? Even if you didn't do anything this month of Ramadan, it still remains that there's still time left for you to be from those utaqa, those people that are freed from the fire. So there are great reasons for hope, but there are also great reasons for fear. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah only accepts from the righteous. There are reasons to have great hope, and there are also reasons to have great fear. So ultimately, Ramadan, like every time of the Muslim, is a time between hope and fear. And the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. And that hope and fear remain like those two wings of the bird. When you feel that despair, or you feel that you haven't got anything accepted from you, or you feel that there is nothing left for you to do because of how, you know, how down you feel and despairing you feel, then at that time you need to increase the hope. Rather, you need to increase the hope before it gets to that point. And when you feel that things are too easy, and everything is going to be accepted from you, and it doesn't matter about the sins you do, or you see those sins to be insignificant, so you need to increase more fear. Rather, before you reach that stage, you need to increase in fear. So the two balance each other out. And like some of the scholars said, in the times when you're healthy and you find ease, those are the times you should have more fear. And in the times when you're sick and maybe you're struggling, those are the times you should have more hope. And a person balances between the two like that. And that's part of what we can take from this month of Ramadan. That's what Allah made easy for me to mention, and Allah knows best. Wassalatu wassalam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.